How are you?
I'm Helen, and we're going to do the unboxing of a Kulzer HiLite Power 3D light curing unit. For that, we're going to need a cutter, a flathead screwdriver, and a Phillips screwdriver. Let's get to work. Let's see what we have inside the box. Inside the box, we have several things. We have this little box that includes the light source, the screen filter, and also the alligator clamps. We also have these platforms with spikes. The spikes should be used inside the chamber facing them. We also have two cables, one with the European plug and one with the American plug. The equipment has the capacity to operate at 110, 115 and 220 volts. We also have here the instructions. The instructions are very important. It always should be followed. I encourage you and advise you to read them. Let's take the equipment out of the box. First, we remove the foam, and here's the equipment. Inside this box, we have another box, so this is very protected. We also have the instructions on how to install the bulb. We also have more foam to protect it. And we have a few things here. We have the alligator clamp. The alligator clamp will be placed above the platform. Remember always the spikes facing down, and this will hold the work. We also have here the filter screen, which you can see. Now, remember to never touch the bulb with your bare hands. You have to always grab by the metal. So let's do this very carefully. And this is how it looks. To install the bulb and the filter, we have to make sure that the device is not connected to the power outlet. Now, we are going to install the bulb. First, we need to use a Phillips screwdriver to gain access. So, to remove the door, we need to lift it like this. As you can see, starting with the HiLite Power 3D model, the chip card is already inserted. In previous models, it had to be inserted manually. So let's first install the filter and the bulb. Here, we have the filter. The filter, you can hold it by the edge, and it needs to be placed in the exact spot of the little edges that you will find. Now, in order to install the bulb, remember do not touch the bulb with your bare hands. Only hold it by the metal part. These plugs will go in and then you will place it, tilt it. You will push it, and once it's inside, you have to rotate it and you have to find the right spot where it goes, and then you just have to push. The bulb, the chip, and the unit have the same serial number. This is for warranty reasons. The chip card is used to store information about the unit and the elapsed operating hours. Now we're going to close the device. So we only have to put it here and screw back with a Phillips screwdriver. The HiLite Power units generate a lot of energy. Therefore, also, they generate heat. In long exposure times or continued use of the HiLite Power, the parts sometimes get very hot. However, the heat does not lead to any disadvantage or any reduction of the performance of the product. Some people refer to these devices as light curing ovens. The truth is that they are not ovens because they're not supposed to bake or overheat the workpiece. This specific device is designed to not exceed 60 degrees Celsius because it is proven that when composites are processed at higher temperatures than 60 degrees, they lose physical properties. Therefore, light curing devices for lab composites are not furnaces, and they differentiate by the light source and the light output. In this case, we have a xenon stroboscope lamp in the curing area of 9 centimeters of the app. Below the polymerization chamber, right here, we have a filter which protects the interior of the device from dust. This is the filter. This filter can be cleaned with pressurized air. This is the HiLite type plate. Here we find, among other things, information about the type of fuse to be used. And this one is the fuse holder. Here we have the voltage selector. An important thing to know is the location of the fuses, as well as their specs, which can be found on the type plate, as mentioned. The equipment uses European type fuses. This is the voltage selector, where we choose the voltage according to the mains voltage we work with in our lab. To change the settings, we use a flathead screwdriver. In most Mexican labs, we will find between 110 and 120 volts, and therefore, we can select here the 115 volt position. In most European countries, we would choose 220V position, as this is the main voltage there. This is also the position to choose if we have a biphasic installation of 220 volts in our laboratory. Very important, do not switch this voltage selector while the device is on, because the device could be damaged. Once we have selected the correct voltage, we've installed the light source and the filter. Now we have to connect the device to the power outlet. So remember, we have two cables. One is for the American connection and another one for the European one. Then we turn on the device. After switching on, the device performs a self-test, and if everything is okay, a small green light turns on. This means that the device is in optimal condition and we can use it. Let's talk a little more about what we can do with this equipment. It has 6 different operating modes. The first one is a 6 seconds that is used to fix or freeze a composite layer. That means, for example, that when you have model and anatomical detail that you already like and you don't want to change, you can freeze it, so to speak. This makes that modeling complex anatomical structures much easier, and it can be done in several steps. However, the freezing of anatomical details does not mean that the material has already been completely polymerized or hardened. For this purpose, this device has a 90-second cycle, which is this one. To activate it, we press the button marked 90 seconds, and it also says 10 minutes, but we're gonna push it briefly. If we press the button for more than 2 seconds, the cycle of 10 minutes is activated. This is indicated acoustically by a signal tone. In addition, there is also a visual indicator. Blue flashing light like this one means the shorter polymerization time indicated on each of the 3 keypads has been selected. A steady blue light means that the longer time has been selected. The device offers a total of 6 polymerization cycles. 6 seconds, 90 seconds, 180 seconds, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and 15 minutes. The last three cycles are designed to cure work pieces made in our cara print 3D printing system. Each material used in the cara print 3D printer has its own curing time. It is important to mention that the drawer of the device is locked during operation and cannot be opened. If we try to open the drawer anyway, the device gets blocked. In this case, we must wait until the rest of the program time has elapsed. We hear a click and the drawer is unlocked, and the indicator light will stop flashing. At the end of the process, we get three beeps from the device. Only then we can open the drawer. So let's do a demonstration. Did you hear the click and the beep? Now we can access the polymerization chamber. So you can use this platform and the alligator clamps to hold your piece, and then you can put it inside the chamber to be polymerized. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing of the HiLite Power 3D. Please like this video and subscribe to our Kulzer channel in YouTube. See you next time.